So a very good morning, everyone. Welcome back to our online class, and I'm so delighted to come back again. Anyway, everyone, how was your weekend? And where did you go for your weekend, everyone? And did you have a nice time with your families and friends? All right, so everyone, I hope that you are ready for our online class this morning. And did you submit your homework and classwork to your homeroom teacher? I believe that right now it's more convenient for all of you regarding the homework and classwork, right? Because I designed the classwork and homework through the Google form so that it's easier for you to access, and also you don't need to spend much time on copying the classwork and homework into your notebook at all, right? You just click on the link and also do the exercise on that Google form. And I would like to encourage all of you to do both classwork and homework, because classwork and homework, they help you a lot for your progress test and for your final exams. And one more thing, please don't forget to review your lesson, because you are going to have your progress test too very soon. And if you have any questions or if you don't understand any lessons, you can go back to my previous videos and watch them again, because I believe my previous video help you a lot for your review, alright? So everyone, right now I would like to draw your attention to our lesson today. Today's section, we are going to move to a new lesson in the Blueprint book, which is lesson 5, Smart Homes. And also today I'm going to focus on grammar point. And as you can see, the grammar point that I'm going to introduce to you today is about present simple passive. So everyone, do you still remember the grammar point that you have learned in the previous section that related to passive? Alright, so in the previous section, I introduced you about the past simple passive and past perfect passive, right? And in today's section, I will draw your attention to present simple passive. So everyone, regarding the present simple passive and past simple passive, it's not much far different at all. So the difference is only about the form, right? And the usage of that present simple passive and past simple passive. All right, so everyone, I would like to review again regarding the passive and the active of the sentence, all right? In order to remind you again about the passive sentence. So everyone, as you already know that in English, it has two voices, right? Active voice and passive voice. And the active voice is used when the subject of the sentence does the action, right? When we want to focus on who or what does the action. But for the passive voice, it's used when we want to emphasize the actions, the verb, and the object of the sentence rather than the subject. So, which simply means that for the passive voice, it's used when we want to focus on the object in the active sentence, all right? So everyone, for the passive voice, we take the object in the active sentence to be the subject, because we want to focus on the actions, right? Or we want to focus on who or what receive those actions. All right, so everyone, right now let's move to our present simple passive. So here, as you already see the example that I show all of you in my second slide here. Here you see the two example. One is the active voice and the other one is the passive voice. So everyone, can you read for me number one, the example? I would like you to look at this example for a few seconds and also analyze these two sentences. What the difference between the active voice of the present simple and the passive voice, right, of the present simple. All right, so the example number one, my mom sings that song, all right? So the sentence is the active voice, and number two, that song is sung by my mom. So the sentence is the passive voice. So as you can see, my mom in the active voice, it is the subject, right? Sings, it is a verb, right? That song is the object of this sentence. So my mom sings that song. So we want to focus on the subject, my mom, right? So we want to address the person that does that action. So we use the active voice. However, when we want to focus on the object of the active voice, we need to change it to the passive voice. As you can see, the example number two, that song is sung by my mom. So we do not focus on who or what does the action, but we focus on what that received the action. So we want to focus on that song, all right? So we take the object in the active sentence, that song, to be the subject in the passive sentence. So it becomes that song, and then we need to include a verb to be is, right? And then you see the verb in the active voice we use sing, but in the passive voice it changed to sang, right? Sang here, sing, sang. So sang here, it is in the past participle verb, right? Form, which is in verb 3, by who? By my mom, all right? So everyone, when it is important to know who does the action, we use by. As you can see here, it is important, right, to know who does that action, right? So who does that action? Everyone of singing the song. So my mom, right? So we use by my mom. And the noun follows by is called the agent, all right? So my mom here, it is called the agent, all right, in this sentence. So my mom was the subject in the active sentence, but it becomes the agent in the passive sentence, as you can see here, by my mom. All right, so everyone, let's move to our next slide. So as you can see the example here, this sweater is made in China. All right, so everyone, do you see the word by anymore? You don't see the word by, right? You might wonder why in this passive sentence we do not include the word by at all. So sometimes when the action is unknown or unimportant to the meaning of the sentence, we do not use by at all. As you can see, this sweater is made in China. So we do not know who does the action or who made that sweater at all, right? We just know that it was made in China, right? So, and also one more thing is, it is not important to know who made that sweater. So we just want to focus that sweater is made in the China, all right? So everyone, right now let's look at the form of the present simple passive. So I think it's very easy, and also it's not that difficult at all. So everyone, here is the form of the present simple passive. As you can see, we have be plus past participle, all right? Past participle here, it is the third form of the verb that we can say, verb 3, right? Be here is the verb to be, am is are, all right? So everyone, are you clear with the form of the present simple passive? So am is are here, we change it based on the what, everyone? Based on the subject of the sentence, right? So it depends on the subject that we use. So everyone, right now let's take a look at more examples relating to the present simple passive. First column, it is about the affirmative sentence, which is the positive sentence. Second, negative sentence, and third questions, all right? So here the second row, it is the active sentence, and the third row, it is the passive passive sentence. So everyone, let's look at the affirmative column. Ben walks the dog, all right? So Ben walks the dog. So here we want to focus on the subject. Ben does the action, right? Walk the dog. However, when we want to focus on the one that received the action, the object, the dog here, so we change it into the passive sentence. So it becomes the dog is walked by Ben. So the dog is, we need to plus verb to be is, and then we need to plus the verb past participle that we can say verb 3, and then by who? By Ben, all right? So Ben here, it is the agent in the sentence, right? And everyone move to example number 2. They make cookies here, all right? So here, when we want to change it into the passive sentence, it becomes cookies are made here, all right? So here, we do not know who does the action at all, but we just know that the cookies, they are made here, all right? And look at the negative sentence. So for the negative sentence, it's not different from the positive sentence at all. We just add not, all right, into the sentence. Ben does not walk the cat, all right? So we can say the cat isn't walked by Ben. And move to the next example. They don't make sandwich here. So sandwich and made here. How about question form, everyone? So question form, we just use the verb to be to the front, all right? To have in the question form. Or if you have the WA question in the sentence, so you need to start your passive sentence with WA question and then with the verb to be. So everyone, the first question, does Ben walk the rabbit? So we can say, is the rabbit. So rabbit, the rabbit here, it is the object in the active sentence, but when we change it into the passive, it becomes the subject. Is the rabbit walk? Walk here, we change it to verb 3, right? Is the rabbit walk by Ben, all right? How do they make the cookies? So here the WA question, so we need to put it again in the passive form. How and then plus verb to be, how are the cookies made? Alright, so everyone, right now let's take a look why we need to use the present simple passive form, alright? Why and when, alright? So everyone, the passive voice, it is often used first of all, when we want to talk about art, science, or literature, all right? So I would like you to remember this one. So it is very useful for all of you, all right? So when you want to focus on art, science, or literature, we usually use passive voice, all right? For example, as you can see here, the scientific method is used for experiment. So here, when we focus on the scientific, the example of science, all right? The scientific method is used for experiments, all right? And number 2, when we want to explain directions and instructions. So usually when you want to explain to someone about the directions or the instruction about something, you often use the passive voice, all right? You can go to the instructions on the some equipments or instruction on how to use something. You can notice that they often use the passive voice, right? For example here, baseball is played with 9 players on the team, all right? So here the instruction, right, of baseball. Baseball is play here, it is the present simple passive. Baseball is played with the 9 players on the team. And last of all, for the passive voice, we often use it in the news reports and academic writing, all right? So if you go to the CNN, BBC, if you listen to some news on the TV, you will notice that they usually use the passive voice, right, in their report. And also for the academic writing, sometimes when you want to like I can say paraphrase the sentence from the internet, you usually use the passive voice, right, in order to avoid plagiarisms. And academic writing, it is very important for all of you, for you that you should know how to avoid plagiarisms, and also you know how to paraphrase the sentence. So when you paraphrase the sentence, you need passive voice to help you, all right? So everyone, as you can see here, the example, the environment is studied by many scientists, all right? So here it is the, I can say the academic writing, right? The environment is studied by many scientists, all right? So everyone, again, for the passive voice, you need to remember that we use it to talk about art, science, or literature, and second, if you want to explain directions or instruction to somebody else, we should use passive voice. And also last but not least, the important point that you need to note down, when people report the news, or when you want to paraphrase the sentence in your academic writing, you can use passive voice to help you, all right? So everyone, right now it comes to the end of my first session today, and I hope that you get something from my lesson. And also if you have any questions, you can drop your questions in your group, alright, so that your homeroom teacher can help you. And everyone, right now it's time to say goodbye, and also enjoy your break, everyone. See you in the second session.